Hey everyone, Tech Steve here, and this is the second video that we're doing on the AU8000 Samsung television. Now, last year, Samsung came out with the TU8000 that had the Crystal UHD processor in it, and this one also has the Crystal UHD processor that runs off of Ford processors. Now, one of the big improvements is last year's model had 5.5 Tizen, where this one has 6.0, but they did remove a feature called Ambient Mode from the new AU8000. Maybe they figured they'll just put it more in the QLED series, or it was a feature that a lot of people didn't use. In this video, we're gonna take a deep dive into some picture quality samples, as well as some gaming. And on top of that, I'm gonna show you guys some features that you can do with this television set. So sit back and relax, and let's get started. First thing we're going to talk about is this panel. This is an edge lit VA panel, and the benefits is that it has better colors as well as better viewing angles. But let's go and test it out just a little bit more. For this test, we're going to check the viewing angles. Right now we're in the front of it. Let's move the camera over here to the side. And the viewing angle seems to be pretty good overall. I don't see any problems that you'll have with that. And that's generally going to give you roughly about 179 degrees or something like that. So viewing angles are good. Now, we'll tell you this TV set can really clean up the signal if you're watching like soccer or anything that has a lot of fast action. If you look at that very bottom line right above the picture, you can see that it's really jerky. But if you go into your settings and then under picture, go to expert setting modes, this particular TV and a lot of Samsung has this feature called picture clarity settings. When you go in there, you can see that it's off right now. And if I go to auto, you'll notice that everything looks a lot more smoother, and maybe they'll give you what they call that soap opera effect. Now, let's say, for example, you don't want to choose automatic. You can go down here and choose custom. And then let's click on judder. That's with the judder all the way on 0. And then here it is all the way on 10. Now, what judder does is that, let's say for example, you're watching something that was filmed in 24 frames per second. This basically matches it with your television set. All right, so here's an example of a contrast test. And one thing I noticed is that on this bottom line, you can barely make it out. So that's telling me that it doesn't really have that great a contrast when it comes to some of the different grayscales. So if you go ahead and go into your settings, you can go up here to the different picture modes. So that's natural. Still, that bottom line is not showing up that good. We can go into movie mode. Now I can see a little bit more, but it made the picture more of a warmer color. And then we have film mode. I can see a little bit more. And back to dynamics, where again, you can't make it out that well. Now this test is showing how well they aligned the TV set when they built it. And I would say Samsung did a really good job on this. In fact, that's more like the 4K line right there. Everything seems to line up very well. So whatever you see on this TV set, it's going to be more absolute than, for example, the 6 series I did from TCL. And here's another example of the screen alignment. Really good job, Samsung. And this test right here shows the different colors in the TV set. Let's try some of the different picture profiles to see if it changes. So right now I have it in standard mode. There's natural mode, it gets a little bit brighter. There's movie mode, just a little bit darker. Filmmaker mode. And then there's dynamic mode. Now, one thing I wish Samsung did is drop this menu down to the bottom whenever you hit the different picture profiles, so you can see the whole screen instead of just half the screen. The last thing we want to check on the screen is the gray uniformity. Now, what this will do is show us any kind of difference between a solid picture or if there's any type of vertical banding. So let's take a quick look at this to see what we see on the camera. You can see the camera picks up right here in the center. But let's go over here to more of the darker grayscale. And again, you can see just a little bit of banding right there and around the edges. But overall, I will tell you, looking at this TV set directly, it looks pretty good. I know that these tests out here are designed to scare people, But I will tell you that this is just something to show you the details of what your television set can do. So what does everything I just showed you mean? Well, it means this. If you're watching something that has a lot of gray in it, you may see some kind of vertical lines or a little bit of ghosting in the center of the television set. Now, if you watch something that has a lot of colors, like cartoons or anything that's animated, you're gonna notice that the color's gonna really pop. Now, in addition to that, since it is a VA panel, what that's gonna allow you to have is better viewing angles. So if you have the TV set in the center, they'll be able to see this AU8000 just fine. Now let's go ahead and hook up the PS5 and show you guys what it looks like on some gaming. And I will tell you, the game Dirt 5 is really fun. Now I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like on a gaming console. So I'll have a PS5 over here. Let's go ahead and set it up. Now the video options, you can see that this is a 38x40x2160 and it runs at 60 Hertz. Again, this is not a 20 Hertz television set. Now, if you look at the bottom, the PlayStation is enabled for 120 Hertz output if your TV set supports it, but the AU8000 does not. So we need to go here and adjust the HDR just to get it ready to go. Again, just dim it just till you can barely see it. So once you got the HDR, I'll adjust it. That's pretty much it. So for the videos, I purchased Dirt 5 and this game does run at 120 Hertz. But since it's not a 120 Hertz television set, it will downgrade back down 60 Hertz, which is okay. This TV set does a good job there. Now this TV set does not have the gaming pop-up on it, but what you can do is go down here to General. Then you can go down to where it says External Device Manager, and these are all your settings. So you can see it's set up with HDMI CEC for auto detection. It's also set up with the automatic gaming mode, but you can turn it off if you like. And another thing you can do is go down here where it says game and HDR and you can toggle that off or on. But if you're looking to get brighter games, you want to go ahead and use this because it does use the HDI technology that's going to allow the content to be as bright as possible according to the way that the software was developed. And that's pretty much all the gaming settings that you have on this TV set.
WWE 2K Universe, the phenomenal one, AJ Styles, welcomes you to the WWE.
This should be an incredible matchup. I mean, both men have extensive offensive repertoires, lasting endurance, and an insatiable appetite to be number one.
And I wouldn't at all be surprised if this match stole the show here.
Styles gets his burst, but you think he's down.
All right, let me put this game down so I can finish up this video. Just having way too much fun. So a lot of people ask me how good is the gaming on this television set, and I think since I'm not a big gamer that I may not know the difference like you guys, but for me everything was smooth. I didn't see any glitches, and I showed you guys the actual footage of me playing the game, so it worked out really good. Now I know you guys want HDMI 2.1, but I will tell you, this 43-inch TV set retails for $429 US. So if you really want HDMI 2.1 with a gaming port, double your budget or more to be able to get that feature, because you're not going to be able to get it on a budget TV, unfortunately. Now, a lot of these TV sets have a feature called eARC, which is HDMI 2.1, but here's the kicker. It's only for audio. So basically, if you have a Dolby Atmos speaker and you want to hook the TV up to it, you're watching Netflix or something that has Dolby Atmos sound, the sound can come out of this TV through the HDMI cable and give you that 7.1 surround sound. So that's what eARC is really all about. Now, I'm a person who likes sound bars or external audio systems, but since I live in a condo, I can't really have the system that I used to have. But I will tell you that this has a 10 watt by 2 amplifier. So let's take a listen and see what you guys think. So overall, the speakers sound really good when it comes to clarity. Vocals sound good, regular TV sounds good, anything that has a really light note of music sounds really good. Now, when it comes to something that has a lot of heavy bass, forget about it. The TV's this thin, you're never gonna get a true bass response. So if you're some type of person who loves bass, you definitely wanna get a soundbar or something that has a lot bigger speaker system in it. So it's not bad, but it's not good either. So now let's go ahead and show you guys some more features that this television set can do. Now, since this TV set has a built-in internet browser on it, you can use a keyboard and mouse. It will work off Bluetooth, but I'm gonna use a USB dongle. Now, to use a web browser, again, you would hit the house on the remote control, and then you would scroll over to where it says internet. Now, on the back of the TV set, I did plug in the keyboard and mouse, and you can see I can use the mouse right here. Now here's the thing, if you go to a website like YouTube that plays HTML5 videos, that's fine, but if you're trying to use like a pirated website that has a bunch of movies on it, the chances are that it will not play those type of files, so you can try it, but I just don't recommend it. Plus, it's not safe to travel websites like that. And with keyboards, I can take you guys over to my secondary website. It's called techstevesd.com. And this is a website I'm putting together that has a comparison guide on it, but I will tell you, I've been so busy that I haven't been adding new products or cleaning everything up like I should. But if you wanna go compare some different TV sets, you can see this is a website that you can visit. And once you click on two different TV sets, it'll show you a comparison, but I still need to fill in like the panels and some more detail on each of these TV sets to give you an idea. This Samsung and most Samsung TV sets will play off a USB drive or play files off a portable hard drive. Now here's the trick. You need to make sure that these are formatted in the correct way. In fact, since I have an Apple computer, I had to format them with the EXFAT format so it could read the files. Now if you was to buy a Samsung television set and you want to access the USB drive, all you need to do is hit the house on the remote control, and then you're going to go over here to where it says source. Click on here and you can see it says USB flash drive. Now there's another way. If you go over here to where it says connection guide, press on that. This shows everything that you can connect to the television set. But if you go down here to the bottom where it says external devices, you can see there's an option for USB flash drives or hard drives. Now if you use a hard drive, you need to make sure it's formatted the correct way and you have it plugged into the 5-volt USB on the back of it. Now back to the USB flash drive, we can go and press on it. And these are some files I put on there just to see if it works. So for example, there's some music. I can just press on the OK. And then on the side of it, you can see there's a playlist. At the bottom here, you can turn off the picture, which is pretty cool. Now you can listen to music without having the picture. All you need to do is hit OK on the remote control and it turns the picture back on. You also have a shuffle feature and a repeat feature. And let's say, for example, you have your family out, you took some pictures and you load them onto a thumb drive. You can even play pictures. Now at the bottom of it, you have a play. However, it will do a slideshow if you have more than one picture on there. And it will play video files as well, but refer to the owner's manual to see which formats that it supports. And you can see you have a fast forward, next on the bottom, a repeat, and then you have options where you can rotate them. Now, some of you guys are asking me, how do I turn off the picture and still listen to the music? Well, it's pretty easy. All you needed to do is go down to General, and then there's an accessibility file. If you go here, there's an option right there where you can turn off the picture. So let's say, for example, I have a Spotify plan and I just want to listen to the music but not see the screen. You click here, and then the music will still play. And just hit the remote control, it'll turn the screen back on. But that's how you get access to it. Now, since we're in here, let me show you some other things you can do. You have Apple AirPlay settings. With the Apple AirPlay settings, this will allow you to send any screen from an Apple device, like an iPad, Apple computer or iPhone. Now again, depends on which content, it will not stream certain video content. Again, this is protective to make sure that people are not doing things the wrong way. All right, so last thing I'm gonna show you guys is the voice command. So let's say, for example, if I go under general in the settings and then press on voice, I can press okay. And then it's gonna take me to this screen where I can choose which voice assistants I want to use. Now keep in mind, this is a USA model, so it could vary depending on where you live at in the world. So we're gonna go down here to Amazon. Once I use the barcode on the screen and sign it to my Amazon account, it took me right to this screen right here. Then you can start using voice commands. Open up YouTube app. You can open up just about any application. You can also ask for weather. But if you notice on the side of my television set, you see a blue light. Watch this. Turn all lights red. See, the TV will control things that are already set up with your Amazon system. Turn all lights off. Now the ones on top are through another setup, but you can see that it turned off the Echo Glow. So these are some things you can do. And if you have the Google Assistant connected, you can also control a lot of their stuff through this television set. And that eliminates having to have Google devices around your house or Alexa devices around your house. So remember, this is part two. So if you haven't watched the first video, make sure you go check that out as soon as you end this video. In that video, I go over the unboxing of it, the remote control, and a lot more details of the TV set. With that being said, I think this TV set fits very good in today's world. I mean, people are wanting a lower price and more features, but what some of these companies are doing is just really changing the design. Like this one's thinner than last year model, but there's no frills that really sticks out to me. There was one takeaway that really was noticeable, and maybe some people won't notice, is the ambient mode. And basically what that allows you to do is kind of put the TV on the wall like a picture frame and have your family pictures and decors, you know, kind of going off of it. That feature is gone. But other than that, the design is good. I like the remote control. The picture has really good colors on it. But I'm so excited to do a comparison test between this one and the TU-8000. And again, you'll start seeing those videos soon after my big announcement in about a week or so. But until then, let's not go into which one is better until we get that test done. So I'm Tech Steve. Make sure you go and give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.